In quest for more knowledge, I had to leave my comfort zone, Nigeria, to embark on a study visit to a nearby African country to learn more about sustainable agriculture on a commercial scale. And of all units visited, I'll only be reviewing the snail sector in this video. Major topics like the way it's being set up, the model the farm operates on, the feeding regime, and the advantages and disadvantages of this system will be touched in this video. If you are new to the channel, remember to like and subscribe to the channel to enjoy more useful content I'll be uploading regularly on this channel and to stay notified when I release such video. So without wasting much of our time, let's go! Starting from the ground, the floor is covered with plantain and banana leaves and lots of palm fronds. This is to give an environment for the snails to rest in during the day. As we know, snails are nocturnal animals, they rest during the day and they are active at night. Roofing sheets are placed in strategic places in this system, and this is used as the feeding platforms where the feeds are placed and the snails can access the feed conveniently in this system. Big stones are arranged throughout the farm to form a walkway in such a pattern that allows you access the farm conveniently without stepping on the floor, where you end up stepping on the eggs, the hatchlings or snails. And also, the water is supplied in this system using an automated water system where there is a tank where the water is, and these sprinklers over here are the ones used to dispense the water in this system. Convenient, right? Various trees and broadleaf plants such as plantain, banana, pawpaw and cocoyam are planted in this system also to form canopy and to reduce the rate at which sun penetrates into the system. As we all know, snails love cool environment. Look at this cocoyam, it's taller than I am, wow. And the whole area is camped with a low fence. This low fence system also poses its disadvantages depending on the area you are. If you are in an area where the predators are plenty, you know this provides an easy access for the predators into the system where you are raising your snails. So you might also want to consider that depending on the kind of environment you are. Now to the feeding aspect. The snails are fed with two kinds of feed, the formulated feed and also fruit waste. The fruit waste in this case is gotten from the same farm. Just take a look at their pineapple plantation. Wow, right? One of the major advantages of this system is that snails multiply quickly in this system, and this is as a result of the natural environment being simulated for the snails, and this increases the rate at which the snails mate, which results in high egg production. But the disadvantage with this system is that the hatchability of the eggs in this system is low, and this is as a result of the little or no impact of the snail farmer in the hatching process of the eggs. So this can also be seen in this system with various eggs lying around in the system. So what can be done in this system is that when you see such eggs laying around, you can pick up the eggs and you incubate them yourself. So that's one of the disadvantages of this system. The mortality of snails in this system can also be high, especially that of the hatchlings, the baby snails. Though this can be corrected by adjusting some factors in this system. To know how to build or construct a snail greenhouse, I'll be releasing the link in the description down below to the video where I taught how to build the snail greenhouse and also how to set up the vegetation, and another video on the snail free range system. So you can do well to check that in the description box below after viewing this video. And also, if you are looking forward to setting up a free range system, whether it's a low fenced or something of this nature. All you need to do is understand all the snail needs, all the factors, so you'll be able to simulate those factors to suit the snail's need, as to reduce the mortality rate, to increase your productivity and the efficiency of the system. So remember to like and subscribe to the channel to enjoy more useful content I'll be uploading in the future, and to stay notified when I release such content. So till next time, peace. Peace.